I'm here at this Culver's chicken restaurant to meet the nerd I found on the internet, and you can thank me later. Let me explain. I'm gonna be honest and fair about something. I don't like the interior or the dash of the sixth generation Ford truck. I am one of the biggest fans of the sixth generation board. I think it's the manliest thing ever made. I think it's a truck's truck. I think it's the truck to end all trucks. I think it's the best, it's the truckiest truck. It's what I think when I think truck. But when I look at the dash, I just see something struggling to get to the 80s where everything sucked and everything was boring and thought that it was futuristic, but it wasn't. And I don't like it. I don't like this cart, especially. This I can deal with. This, yes, I'm upside down here. This I can deal with, but I think could be better. This, I remember as a kid, I remember this, and I kind of like this feel, this vertical stacked feel over here, but all this is just terrible and I hate it. And so I did a video a while back, whenever we were doing the truck, where I just kind of did my best at trying to make it not that with what I had on hand. So we got some Equus gauges, which by the way, were trash. I'd say, if I remember correctly, it was about a 50% failure rate on those gauges. I don't remember which ones specifically failed, but just out of the box, some of them, and then within 1,000 miles on some others. So if you're gonna do a bunch of gauges, I recommend just dropping a dime on them because those cheap ones sucked. Anyway, just kind of took that old piece and then, you know, put some gauges in there and it looks a little bit better, but it's still lame. So got the 73 and it's a beautiful work of art, and we've got the 2010, 2015, something, I don't know. And I hate it. I hate that's a big beautiful truck. But rather interior, man, this specifically, I like this. And I think if it was a little bit smaller and maybe made of actual aluminum, then it would look really cool over there in that. And I also like this kind of minimalist thing they've got going on with the controls here for the heater and then the screen and then these again. And I think that I could find some kind of way to pay homage to the one part of Dad's big dumb truck that I like by putting it in my truck and replacing the one part of my truck that I don't like, which is all this. I don't know. I think that I could make something to replace this whole bezel with, and these gauges, and this. I think it can be done. Probably more expensively than I need to, but I think it should be like a reward thing. You know what I mean? Once I get it back on the road and I like get the interior kind of done otherwise, and then it's like the one thing that's left is this dash, this custom dash. So I've even thought things like, what if the pad was wood, like dark walnut, and there'd be some dark walnut, like handrests, and just go all out, just make a Bentley interior, you know? I was trying to think, what should I do to pull that off? And I started thinking about a hobby that I picked up a couple years ago, 3D printing. Now, I don't have a 3D printer right now because it didn't survive my most recent move, but I had one that was big enough to print a helmet to go on my melon, because...
This is the way.
This is the way. This is the way.
So, I learned how to do this, and it was fun, and I'm gonna get back into it, and I was thinking, can we do this in reverse? So I started looking into it, and it turns out we can. 3D scanning is a thing, and like 3D printing, it was very difficult and annoying for a long time, and the exclusive purview of nerds with a lot of money. And I found one of those nerds with a lot of money on Facebook Marketplace who was willing to, for a nominal fee, take this, which this is when I ordered on eBay because I didn't feel like peeling that one off. Plus, I'd already chopped that one up, and this one's more intact. It has something weird going on here with the radio. If somebody could tell me what this shape is, because I tried Googling and trying to find something, because I know the one that has like the square, two dots, you know? But a lot of those, I remember getting wallered out for the big rectangle, you know, in the 90s, whenever you hook up your Pioneers and your Rockford Fosgate, you know, under the seat. But I don't remember this shape. So anybody knows what this shape is for, I'd love to hear it. But anyway, I got this on eBay. This guy had it for $20. I think I sent an offer for like $10, and he accepted it. And so then I got this, and then I found this guy on Marketplace, and I met up with him, gave it to him, and he put all these little dots all over it because he had a little bit of a intense old school scanner that got like really, really detailed, right? And so then he gave me the file, and it was huge. And that's where he saw me at the chicken place. There we were at the chicken place while he showed me some stuff. The file was just way too detailed, like a trillion polygons. So then I went on Fiverr, because I don't know SolidWorks very well. I can do Blender a little bit, just enough to look at things. And just had somebody do the reverse engineering rebuild on what we had scanned here and try to repair some of the holes, because some of these holes are blown out and some of the parts are broken. But there's enough here that the scan, the 3D artist was able to like recreate what I think is a pretty good representation of this part. So from that, I will eventually learn a SolidWorks or Fusion 360 or find someone who does to build this from this platform into something that I want it to be. And if someday I get it printed out of aluminum for $1,000 and make that be my reward for the interior, maybe that's what happens. But I've started the process, and it made me realize that the 3D scanners now that are coming out are eminently affordable compared to prior generations and usable for things like this. So I was thinking, I will save up at some point to get a scanner and then maybe get a whole sixth generation Ford simply for the purpose of open sourcing it and taking every piece off of it and scanning it and putting it up online so that you can do whatever you want with it. A 3D scanner would cost, at this point, $300 to $600 to get one part like this scanned. You know, people will charge you between $20 and $100, and so it's not feasible. So if I can eventually find a cheap scanner and then find a cheap truck, I'll do that. Or maybe I'll do an Indiegogo or a tip jar or something to see if people want me to open source a 6th gen Ford with a scanner. And if so, we just need to probably get $1,000, probably, scanner and an old truck. So I will find a website to put the scan of this on. Hopefully like a free one or something. If there's some way for you to give me some money for you taking the scan of this and doing whatever you want with it, 3D print it as it is, or modify it to some kind of whatever you would like it to be, and then make that available for other modifiers, whatever you want. Maybe there'll be some kind of button where you can push and give some money. If anybody does give any money for it, it'll just go into a fund to get a 3D scanner and a truck to open source. So let me see what you make.